really damaged ankle.
Well, that's a trifecta of doom right there. Man. Three bad things.
Late starts in their professional career. Hutchinson comes in with the 2-inch height advantage, but it's Bennett at 201 pounds, weighing 8 pounds more than Hutchinson. Hutchinson with the 2-inch reach advantage. All right, let's send it now to Michael Buffer for the pre-fight introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, DiBella Entertainment, along with your undefeated king of beers, Budweiser, and on-site promoter, Cedric Kushner Productions, presents the final bout of the evening of Olympic heroes, sanctioned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The three judges assigned to this bout will be Tommy Kaczmarek, Melvin Olathan, and Steve Weisfeld. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Arthur Mercanti Jr. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the thousands in attendance here at Madison Square Garden and the millions watching around the world on KO Nation, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white trimmed with black and yellow, and weighing in at 193 pounds. His professional record is 1-1 with one draw. He comes to us from Kingston, Jamaica. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Andrew Kane to fight Hutchinson. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing red, trimmed with silver letters, and weighs in at 201 pounds. He's a U.S. Olympian, a co-captain of the team. From Chicago, Illinois, making his professional debut, ladies and gentlemen, here is Michael Bennett.
Good evening, Mike, Andrew. You both received the rules of the next New York State Fighters. Let's have a nice clean fight. Touch gloves. Good luck to the both of you.
Touch gloves.
Right there.
All right.
Michael Bennett lost a tough quarterfinal match to the eventual gold medal winner, three-time gold medal winner, Felix Savone from Cuba. But Bennett said his only dream was to make the Olympic team. He never thought about going professional. He had tunnel vision. He was focused. But his amateur career is now through, and Bennett looks to make a mark in the heavyweight division.
Well, he fought Savone. Savone said that he now... In other words, just like was before him from Cuba, great fighter from Cuba, the father of Stevenson, who won the fight Muhammad Ali on top.
Another three-time gold medal winner.
Exactly. So really, he's been in the ring with a fighter who's been in the ring with everybody, Savone, and has knocked out a lot of other fighters, great from Riddick, Bowen, and the rest of them. So he has some experience, even though he's been only around a little short time.
Bennett releases a 1-2 combination, busting through the defense of Andrew Hutchinson.
Bennett's best strategy for this fight is to get Hutchinson into a mix. Get him to throw punches at him, and as he's throwing, he's got to counter him.
Bennett connects with an overhand right. For a short amateur career, Bennett had great success. He earned a gold medal at the 99 World Championships.
Just like I said, you know, he may not have a lot of fights. He's been boxing a long time because they've been in confinement for prison, but this is always like a preservative, as you see in the black rhino. They've been in jail for a few years. So when they get out, they've been living almost a clean life in prison.
Big right hand from Michael Bennett, and that might be it for Andrew Hutchinson. And now Mercanti Jr. has to step in and break up the fight. Bennett not quitting until he heard any signs. And that's it. Arthur Mercanti Jr. stops the fight. Michael Bennett coming through with a huge splash. A first round knockout over Andrew Hutchinson. He's KO.
Hutchinson's corner trying to make sure that he is all right.
He got some mental after he was hurt. I thought the catch was something soon. I mean, with his head
went back railing like that. I thought that McKenzie Jr. would step in, but I guess he figured that Hutchinson wasn't as hurt as he looked and let it continue.
The right move by Michael Bennett to continue the fight.
Like they say, don't stop punching until the referee stops him. Because I tell you, Hutchinson maybe wasn't as hurt as he looked. He could have came back into a sneak attack.
Michael Bennett wasting no time. Kevin, watch his right hand.
First right hand definitely spent Hutchinson against the rope. Now he's defenseless. He tries to get up. Bennett threw two right hands after that. That was a tremendous shot. McKenzie did the right thing by stopping it. Here goes the same look, the same right hand. Right hand goes. He goes. He's giving it to go down, but he can't. The punches are actually keeping him up. The ropes are keeping him up at this point. One right hand, two right hands. Hutchinson is defenseless. Lucky thing, McKenzie was there to stop it. Here's another look at the same punches, same right hand. You see his head sailing back like that, flinging. McKenzie's pro fighter. Bennett is his man. Very good skills line. McKenzie Jr. saved the day.
Well, and you saw Bennett there. He waited. He expected McKenzie Jr. to jump in, and when he didn't, he just continued to take care of business. All right, let's head up now to Michael Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Arthur McKenzie Jr. has to step in and call a halt to the bout. The official time, 1 minute, 46 seconds of round number one. Winning.